We continue with dummy endpoints. Here is the plan for our API. Now we have created two endpoints for route slash products. Let's continue with routes for a specific product, and then we'll add endpoints for orders. Inside products folder in controller, create a new class getProductById and copy the response code from getAllProducts. Now update the method. It will accept an ID from the request. Why string? Everything we receive from the request will be a string. Later we can cast it to integer if we need. And fix the message here. Done. Create two more controllers here. Update product and delete product. Copy and paste the code from the previous controller. Change the message. Here, to update the product, we use put request. And to delete a product, we use delete request. We are done with controllers for products. Now we need to register routes for them. Get request to slash product slash ID. This regular expression means that we accept only numbers here. And this route will trigger getById controller. Then add two more routes. Put request to update product controller and delete request to delete product controller. Before we start testing these new endpoints, we need to add one more change in our code. Remember that here, in invoke method, we have additional argument, ID. We need to somehow extract this ID from the request and provide it to the controller. Open the router. All matched wildcards and their values can be found in the third element of the array, which has been returned by dispatch method. It is an array with wildcards and corresponding values. For simple routes without wildcards, it will be empty. So we can provide the values from this array right here when we call the controller. And remove this empty line here. Okay, the router is fixed and the routes are registered. Now we can check them. Start the server and open request file. And three requests here. Get product by ID, get request to slash product slash one, then update a product with put request. And delete a product with delete request. Check them. Get, put and delete. Everything works. We are done with dummy endpoints for products. The next group of endpoints is about orders. In the root namespace, create a new folder orders and controller inside. We can copy getAllProducts and create product here. Fix namespaces, titles and responses. Get request to slash orders. Create order. Then for a specific order we need two controllers. Get one by ID and delete. Again we copy these controllers from products namespace. Orders here in namespace. Rename to delete order. Update response with delete request to slash orders slash ID. Orders rename to get order by ID and get request to slash orders slash ID. All required controllers are done. Let's register routes for them. Again, we copy routes for products. We don't need a put request. Replace slash products with slash orders and product with order. clean up the code. Done. Okay, it's time to check. As always, start the server and open request file. Copy requests for products and replace product string with order. Done. Run all these requests. Get all orders. Create a new order. Get order by ID. And delete an order. So all these routes are working. They're not very useful yet, but we already have a basic API. Of course, it is not perfect, not complete, but we are getting there.